Mic on.
What's up, guys? Ragnar and V here. Skyrim again. Episode 49. Coming up on 50. Coming up on 50. Excited about that, I guess. I know I'm excited to play. And I feel like I was figuring out some bugs last time we were playing. Hopefully it's going to be smoother this time. I think we got the improved skeletons, and they seem to do fine against the regular mobs, and they seem to get crushed by the boss. But maybe, you know, skeletons being taken out by a boss is like a reasonable expectation. I don't know. What else? We were discovering that there was one particular character that we like weren't quite able to loot. I still haven't solved the problem with my audio settings not saving. I apologize for that. I guess that's just one other thing for me to fix. Okay. Let's see how we like those settings. Okay, I think we wanted to sleep for a bit. I think our character was lacking in sleep. So let's just take care of that right away. I think we're well fed, or relatively fed. We can feed more before we leave.
Is there
surge of power? Can smell, I do anything for you?
I don't recall addressing you, worm.
Maybe the voice audio is too loud. Yeah, let's tone back the voice audio. Okay.
I thought perhaps.
And
in the unlikely event that I ever require you for some reason,
Serena.
Until then, I see no.
Wanted to meet outside or something like that.
I'll be going now.
Right. Yeah. She coming. What quest do we have selected? Yeah, okay, we got the right quest selected. So we're gonna need to throw on our cold weather gear before we actually go outside. Okay, nice. Our character looks really cool in the sun, in a little bit of sunlight. Okay, head outside. I think she'll follow us, I presume. Daylight out, 4:43 p.m. But it's a little cloudy. We are able to go outside in the daylight, we just have to be like pretty conscious of what we're doing, you know? Or like what the conditions are. She's following us. Yeah. This is like pretty damn bright though, maybe it's too bright. Maybe I need to turn down the water audio as well, it might be too loud. We have a way to get down. Did I get shot by an arrow or what? Because I shouldn't have taken any fall damage. Is there a skeleton next to me that I'm not seeing? The skeletons, but I don't see them. It must be above us or something. There's one up there. There's two up there. Oh shit. Sell that book though, it's probably worth something. Alright. Is that it? I guess. Head inside now. That I'm not seeing.
Who's there?
Shit. to level 12. Flee from combat for 30 seconds. Destruction spells cost 12 less. That's actually kind of good. What ring do I have on? Am I able to wear two rings? No. Alright, but it's still a pretty cool ring though. Okay, we're making some good progress here. There's another skeever apparently. Somewhere. Is this the world's biggest skeever or something? Look at this guy. It's skeleton trying to grab this dagger. Super clear on where I'm supposed to go. There's a dog floating in the water. The fuck do I go? Is it easier to see without the candlelight effect? I don't know how much it's helping. It's kind of hard to say. Okay, so there's an upstairs. How do I get there? Over here? Serena coming. Actually finding a lot of potions along the way, which is great. Alright, I guess we gotta head downstairs apparently. That's not what I meant to click on. God damn it. Fuck. Control-Alt-Delete, close the game, apparently. And then try to reopen this shit. Sorry guys, I don't know what the fuck I clicked on. I just wanted to turn down the, I guess the effects volume, because I'm not sure what it was we were hearing, but it was, like, really loud, really distracting.
Mic off. Mic on.
Okay. This game has like notoriously long loading screens, which is unfortunate. Enjoy the load, I guess. Enjoy the loading screen. Sorry for this, guys. We'll be back. Hopefully, we'll be back on track relatively quick here. Working on it.
Mic off. Mic on.
Okay, so first things first. Yeah, what did I click on earlier? Mods or something? Okay, so we gotta go back upstairs. We can grab this potion. There's another potion over here. Huh, so that animal is still like insanely loud, whatever the hell animal it is. Still like distractingly loud. But whatever. Let's head over there and try to find it and kill it so it can shut the fuck up. I hate how those things like show up like out of thin air. And whatever the fuck Skeever is like below us that's so loud. Jesus. And now another loot bug. Terrific timing for that. Why am I getting these bugs where I like go to loot something and the game fucking crashes? That's so annoying. Happened last night and it happened tonight. Every once in a while I go to loot some really specific corpse and like as in like this exact corpse, this exact specific hound, bloodhound, and the game crashes from looting that hound or whatever. I guess I could do a search to try to determine like if there's some common known causes for that bug, like, I don't know. Damn, that's annoying. Because now I have to adjust the volume settings all over again. Yet again. walk right over a trap without realizing it. I think I do need the candlelight here, it's crazy dark. That helps a little bit. At least we killed that damn spider dude. That was so annoying. Feeling a bit fatigued, okay. Well, but shit, I like raining blood. I slept right before we started this dungeon or whatever.
What happened to this place? Everything's been torn down.
I wonder if I need my cold weather
cloak
for this zone. It's like I think there's a battle here that we're going to be participating in pretty quickly.
This used to lead into the castle's great hall. Looks like my father had it sealed up. I used to walk through here after evening meals. It was beautiful once.
Maybe I want to turn up the voice setting a little higher.
This was my mother's garden. Do you know how beautiful something can be when it's tended by a master for hundreds of years? She would have hated to see it like this. Wait. Something's wrong with the moon dial here. Some of the crests are missing and the dial is askew. I didn't even know the crests could be removed. Maybe my mother's trying to tell us something.
Investigate the moon dial. Two pieces. Also, how warm is our character? Warm. Okay, cool. So would that mean there's a third piece missing? Or, yeah, on the ground somewhere that I haven't seen yet?
Been in those tunnels before, but I bet they run right under the courtyard and into the tower ruins. Well, at least we're getting closer. Let's go.
Nice, dude. All right. Do it up. Probably gonna get attacked by some death hounds. Ruins? Okay.
Who's there?
try to loot some of these. And yeah, hopefully my game won't crash from looting them. I don't know what's been up with that lately. It's not something I'm accustomed to, I'll say that.
Yeah.
Where'd you come from?
Probably not. not going to do any blacksmithing, but Vampire Royal Armor, that looks interesting. Magic regenerates 12% faster. 125% faster. God damn. What's the one we have currently do? 95. That is pretty cool, I have to admit. Oh, but it's light armor. Do I want to sleep for a little bit? Maybe. Must be a chain I can pull or something. Whoa, did you see that? That's actually kind of cool. Or something I can interact with. Possible this is just a dead end and it's not anything more significant than that. Weird. Was there a chain that I could have pulled over here maybe?
We're getting close. I'm sure of it.
What happened to the castle door? I need to train. I think we should part ways.
Turns out my mother was here than I thought. I wonder what she's hiding.
What do I need to do to get through here? Or am I not meant to go this way? Way. And tower or whatever. It does seem like I'm getting a little closer to this quote-unquote ruined tower.
Mic off. Mic on.
Sorry, sneeze. Yes, yes. Filthy from exploring the dungeon. That's to be expected, but... Okay, I think this is that door I was talking about. Thank you. Okay, we're making some progress. Still kind of drawing the conclusion that there must be some kind of puzzle in that room. Yeah, we didn't solve the puzzle, and we need to go back and solve that shit.
Something. Let's take a look around. There has to be something here that tells us where she's gone. My mother was meticulous about her research. If we can find her notes, there might be some hints in there. I remember she used to keep a small journal. See if you can dig it up.
Didn't I find a journal fragment earlier? Sneaking.
Thank you.
Daedric Prince. Clavis Vile. Clavis Vile is the prince whose sphere is power through ritual invocations and pacts, improved conjuration spells, and can make pacts.
You did? Let me see them. I only know what she told me. She had a theory about soul gems, that the souls inside of them don't just vanish when they're used. They end up in the soul cairn. The soul cairn is home to very powerful beings. Necromancers send them souls and receive powers of their own in return. My mother spent a lot of time trying to contact them directly, to travel to the soul cairn itself. That circle in the center of the room is definitely some type of portal. If I'm reading this right, there's a formula here that should give us safe passage into the soul cairn.
What do we need?
A handful of soul gem shards, some finely ground bone meal, a good bit of purified void salts. Oh, damn it. We're also going to need
here.
A sample of her blood, which, if we could get that, we wouldn't even be trying to do this in the first place. Not bad. We'd better hope that's good enough. Mistakes with these kind of portals can be gruesome. Anyway, enough of that. Let's get started. Oh, definitely. Mother would have plenty of those materials in her laboratory. You just need to find them.
Okay. I'll save it here, guys, because I'm gonna spend some time with Amanda and eat some dinner. But, we got something interesting we can pick up on when we come back. Anyway, this is going to be it for me tonight, guys. Everyone take care. Ragnar and V signing out.
Mic off.